Country at this 27th Universiade. We're still with the sprints. We had the individual men's and women's sprints on Sunday. Now the attention turns towards the team sprint. 10 teams making it through to the final. The teams consisting of one man, one woman. The lap is 1.4 kilometres. Each team member needs to go around three times. Six laps. The Russians expected to do well in this. They've got two teams in the final. They were the quickest in the semi-finals. Russia 1 is Anton Gafarov and Svetlana Nikolaeva. Those two both on the podium in the individual events. Gafarov taking second in the men's. Nikolaeva in the women's. The other Russian team, Shakirzianov. Keep an eye out also for the Czech Republic and Srail, Karolina, Grohova, and the third quickest in practice. Two teams from the Czech Republic, two from Kazakhstan, one each from Finland, Schweiz, and Poland, and Japan. Early progress. She had a crash on leg four. The Poles' top spot at the end of the third leg. They ended up coming in ninth. So another excellent day for the Russians.
Dámy a pány, tímto jsme zakončili první ceremoniál 27. univerziády na Strbském plese pro Mixed Team Sprint. Thank you very much. And the medal ceremony will begin and hold the next competition today.
Welcome to the Winter Universiade in Srbske, Slovakia, and it's the first of three Nordic combined events. On Thursday, there's a 10K mass start. On Saturday, a Gundersen. But we're going to kick it off today with an individual Gundersen off the 100-meter hill and then a 10K cross-country to follow it up. This event traditionally dominated by Poland. There are five Polish athletes here, six from Russia, as well as three from Germany and Ukraine, two from the Czech Republic, two from Finland, and one each from Japan, Estonia, and South Korea. A couple of athletes to look out for. Adam Cieslar is the defending champion here, winning this competition 2 years ago. From this Polish team that you can see now, because they did extremely well 2 years ago. So Sczepan Kupczak looks happy with that. First jump.
Oh, I think there. Okay.
Victor Basichnik. And for Ukraine. The three Ukrainians in this competition. How well Poland did 2 years ago.
Slava
Ukraini. Team and individual. By 10 seconds. David Welde. Very much stronger on the cross-country part of this competition. He was 17th in the bronze stars, as we see on the Adam Cieslar here to defend his title. He's one of the favorites, no doubt about that. His team will be happy, don't they? Here's another Pole, Mateusz Wantolok. Looks like a pretty decent jump. He's gone over 98 metres for Poland's Wantolok. What can he do? And that looks extremely long as well. Let's see what the judges say about that, but that's the longest jump so far. From Germany's Tobias Simon. 99 metres, getting 130 points for that. Off to the ski jumping. As you can see, Tobias Simon with 130 points ahead of Mark Schlott and Adam Cieslar. They're the top three. Remember, the cross-country can change a lot. Simon will have a 12-second advantage over Wantolok. Cieslar 32 seconds further back. Kupczak 42 seconds further back as we head into the cross-country section. 10 kilometres. This is the rest of the ski jumping. Those results, anyone at this level probably will have too much to catch up. Although there are many here who are far stronger in the cross-country part of the course. There's a lot of athletes who are here just 13 odd months ago at the last Winter Universiade. Looking to get on that podium. Russia, there's a Nikita Ox, Olevi Vichuk, and Martin Zeman, all those three who competed at the last Winter Universiade.
The next competition, the final event. Assistant technical delegate from
FISU on the start.
So we're ready to go then for the cross country. Will Adam Cieslar hang on to his title? First to go off is Tobias Simon, 12 second advantage over Wantolok. Three poles in fact going right after Cieslar and Kupczak.
Aktualny sezon. Dalszy polski reprezentant startuje. A konkretnie pole Adam Cieslar, 20-letni dziennikarz, dwunastu uczestnicy olimpijskich gier mistrzostw świata. Siedmiokrotny mistrzostw świata w roku 2012.
Adam Cieslar is off.
Trzeci pojazd za sobą, ostatnim czasem 4. Sczepan Kupczak, stawiam do połu. Sczepan Kupczak, ten połu. Trzeci tył jest połu.
Osa, trzeci tył jest połu. Osa, trzeci tył jest połu. Victor Basichnik, five, three to look out for. There could be some other ones bidding for a title. Simon certainly stronger on the ski jump part of his mountain task too long. There's a leader.
Simon, 6th in the Svetlana Universiade.
Nikolaeva. Well, after three and a half goes, Seaman losing his lead. And it's the man who's here to beat Cieslar. You can see he's catching up now. And Tobias Seaman looks a very tired skier indeed, and he's going to be caught. What a surprise, we've had David Welde back in 13th place on the ski jump. Maybe he'll be back for a podium spot. Cieslar, defending champion, looking for a fourth medal overall at the Universiade. And a third gold. Can he hang on to it, I wonder? Adam Cieslar in the lead, but just by a couple of metres. Further back here is a real battle between Sczepan Kupczak and Viktor Pasichnik. Battle for bronze. And at the front, it's the number 13, David Welde is taking the lead. Who wants it most? It's Welde against Cieslar. Germany against Poland, and it's gone to a photo finish. There was absolutely nothing in it. Sczepan Kupczak will get the bronze for Poland, but we need the photo finish for that. Will it be Cieslar again? Let's have another look at that. And the pole, why my word, just has it. And he's going to retain his gold medal. Adam Cieslar of Poland. A photo finish. And poor David Welde, well, he'll go home with the silver. But he couldn't have been closer to getting a gold medal. He gets his first Universiade medal. Adam Cieslar, there you have it. A third gold medal for him in his career. Fourth medal in all. It was a wonderful finish. Adam Cieslar doing just enough. Poland getting the gold medal. David Welde getting the silver. You'll be so spread your wings and fly.
Education meets sport and culture.
On your mark.
What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.